Right guys, today we're going to be doing a walkthrough of Paul Woolford's track Heat. I've made this in Ableton, and if you can't be asked to watch the video, you can download it from my Patreon. This track is a piano house track and it's fairly simple. It's a preview of what we're going to be going through. I got desire for you to hit me up. Right guys, let's start with the piano. It's split into two parts really. One part is this. So it's, I think that's called legato, or yeah, it's long notes. And then there's the rhythm notes. So they're exactly the same chords. These are obviously long and held out, whereas this is chopped off into rhythm. So making the bounciness, I mean, if you want to copy the chords here, feel free. Yeah, so feel free to copy those. I'm not going to go over them in too much detail because it's just piano chords in the day, and I've done that in pretty much every video. But what is the difference with these is in these in-between spaces, they've been filled out with these low notes. So if I mute them, put them back. So yeah, it's like the low notes, it adds a nice bit of rhythm to it. So that, yeah, that sounds really good. In terms of the sound, I've just gone for a grand piano, hardness whacked right up, brightness pretty high, bit of OTT as normal, side chain to the kick, take out some of the low end. We then got this Korg M1, same sort of effects with even a little bit more side chain to the kick. And I've got the House M1 preset. Cool. Yeah, this is then grouped together and we've got a bit of compression. Glue compressor, it's auto filter, which comes in at the start, because if you listen to the original, he does actually take out a lot of the high frequencies before the drop, so it's actually quite dark. So yeah, he's taking out a lot of the high frequencies, and then in the main drop he lets them all in to give it more energy and character. We then got the bass. This sounds like this. Made this in Serum, it's just a saw wave, envelope 1, controlling the filter and the cutoff, MG24, and yeah, if you want to copy that, you can. Distortion, without it, with it, just fizzing it up. I went for the Asim one. Yeah, pretty simple. This is also available on my Patreon, so if you want to download that from there, you can. Then got this saturation. So it's just a preset, warm-up lows, so saturating the low end. If you look at here, 119 Hz, it's making it a bit saturated, and saturate the high end, this one at 5 kHz. Then we've got this EQ. You hear it, it's quite flimsy about it, so this is just really thicking it up around 316. Boosting these frequencies as well makes it really pop on like phone speakers or like laptop speakers and stuff like that. Then again, side chain to the kick, so the kick can punch through. Moving on, we've got the string. So I got this double notes, so C sharp and C sharp again. We then got the same as the, that's exactly the same notes as the piano, but with the C sharp 5 going above it. So it's like a pad with a string. Quite a cool effect. We've got a stereo string preset. So if you go to browser, go to strings, combi, stereo string. It's in there somewhere. I'm not going to bother looking for it, although I kind of want to. Right, we then have, I think it's down this way a bit. Anyway, let's move on. And we then got this pad at the start. Made this in Wavetable. Really simple, same as the piano chords. Oh no, it's actually slightly different. I apologise. So the key we're in, I think, from memory, was A major. So yeah, it's just like an A major 7 and a fifth. Same goes here, so what's that, a B, and that's a B, so that's exactly the same, that's exactly the same, and then it's got like a fifth on top. It's like, I think it's known as a power chord. We've then got this lead. So it's sort of like a belly plaque, just made from a triangle with a lot of reverb without it. It does sound very digital and dry. Cool. So yeah, add loads of reverb. Boost some of the high end. Added some delay as well on a 3-3 setting. Cool. Then got to the top, we've got the drums. They're not the greatest drums, but I don't think the drums in the original are the greatest drums either, if I'm honest. Sorry, Paul, that's just how I feel. Got this kick. And before the drop, we've got this kick. Exact same kick, but it's been high pass filtered. We then have a bit of bit warmer, so that's just a preset of saturation, just making it a bit fatter. And then we've got the drum group again, got a drum bus on it, sounds like this. So it's got a clap from the production hut tech house pack, then we've got this hat from the same pack, we've got this shaker, I think this is a big Z, and then we've got this random shaker, I think from Splice. So yeah, the main takeaway would be that simplicity is key. Really not a lot going on, as you can see. There's only about 6 layers that make up the whole track. The main element I would say would be this beautiful vocal. As you can see, it expands throughout the whole track, so it's all carried. The whole track's pretty much carried by this vocal. But yeah, if you want to download this, you can. It's on my Patreon. Thank you very much for watching. Goodbye.